everyone, and welcome to the Haunted Hollow.
Why, hello there.
Or was it Hallowed Hallow? Either way.
Hallowed.
Hello, how are you doing? So, this is an interesting DLC that we've never played, and we're looking forward to getting it started. We are slightly underleveled for this, but nowhere near how we were underleveled for the badass crater, which we are going back to very, very soon.
Oh, don't you worry.
Yeah.
It will happen.
We are looking forward to that, I think. I hope.
Oh, yeah.
But that's coming up in just a moment. Zombie TK. Oh, I've missed TK so much.
He was the man.
He was the man. Are you ready?
Yep.
Let's talk to him. Okay. I like that this place isn't explained. He just gets right to business.
Yeah, they never mention, like, how or why he was reanimated.
Or why we're here, where we are.
Yeah, I mean, at least with, like, Fallout DLCs, it's the radio that takes you to places, but with Borderlands, it's like, hey, this also exists as a possibility, so come on over.
I mean...
Am I just gonna smash as many of these as possible?
I mean, yeah, sure.
I'm pretty sure you have to smash a certain amount to kill, or to fight the Combustion Crypt Keeper.
Oh, okay. I was just doing this because, like, the Pumpkin Kingpin, how do you get to the Kingpin? Oh, you gotta really mess with him. How do you do that? You kill as many pumpkins as possible.
That is more soundproof logic than a lot that I've heard from you. So, yeah, I'm good
yeah.
with that.
With most Fallout DLC, or not Fallout, I'm sorry, with most Borderlands DLC, they do give you a cutscene kind of explaining the background. No such case for this one, and I thought that was kind of interesting. Also, we're like 3 or 4 years late to this, probably, right?
It came out October 22nd, I think it said, 2013.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to say we missed the boat on this one.
Yeah, exactly. So we have no new revelations to share. This is just our first time experiencing it, and I've done most of the DLC. Ryan, have you done any?
Literally none.
Okay, so we're going to be exploring all of them at some point, hopefully, unless we get real tired of this, or unless you're like, please, God, stop.
Joe, what's the green thing around me?
You picked up a candy, and that gives you a boost.
Temporary or...
Temporary.
I'll make the most of it while I can.
There you go. But as you can see, this is already going way better than our previous, DLC runs have. So, good stuff. We're making some progress.
Ooh, I'm fast now.
Yeah.
Oh god, he's very overpowered. I do not need to fight him right now.
So, okay, there's a magic lock.
Do we have any magic keys?
Not on me. Other pants. Okay.
Check so inside your shoes.
Maybe I have to kill these things. Oh, wait, Kingpin found herself some enchanted bones. We're also playing where we can't hear the audio, so, like, that's an issue. But, you know, we're getting
yeah.
there. Getting through it.
Well, Joey, although we have discussed
here's
it.
Here's a guy.
We could turn the game volume way up and then just have horrible audio quality. Like that.
That
is a possibility.
Good. Yeah. Let's do that.
Do you need assistance? Or?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Okay. Try to get to. If only this were a speed boost, but I think I'll make it.
Halfway there. Okay. Well, I'll be right back then.
All right.
But we are just moving right along. So since there's not really a plot. I mean, there is, but there isn't.
Like, none that I can tell. There is one, but I just have no idea what it is. Like,
yeah. So, I mean, that's all well and good. I do have some things that I'd like to talk about on this episode, because it's a very spooky episode, and as you know, Halloween is one of my favorite holidays.
Oh, it is my absolute favorite holiday.
My second being All Saints Day, and it's so nice that they're back-to-back like that.
Oh, hold on, Joey. I feel like you are missing one thing that I know you're a fan of.
Uh-huh.
Porrim.
Oh, yeah. Porrim is one of my favorite. I want to make it clear. First off, if you're not familiar with Porrim, it is a Jewish holiday Which there is, you know, background to, but essentially you just get shit-faced.
Yeah, and like...
We should do a Porrim special. I don't know how.
We should. And I just want to make one thing abundantly clear. And that is not, like, religiously insensitive of us. Like, the point is actually to get shit... We're not oversimplifying things.
Right. And I actually went to a Porrim celebration a few years back where my friends snuck me into a synagogue. Oh, no, they didn't sneak me in for that one. I just, you know, walked in because I had a friend who was participating in a Porrim play. And then,
Which, by the way, how nice is it that the Hebrew worked out like that? That it's literally called Porrim.
Yeah, exactly. But I got to take a shot with a cantor, and I feel like that's something you don't get to do with most religions.
When you say that, like, what I really want to do now, just to take things to the ultimate extreme,
right,
is to do a keg stand out of a tabernacle.
Well, yeah.
I feel like that's the logical conclusion of this.
Yeah. I feel like you're right. But, you know, it's not Porrim, because Purim's in March or April, and it is October. It is the spooky times. And because of that, I'd like to read you, as I walk off this. That's why you should always pay attention to where you're walking, friends. Stop looking at your phones. So there's a thread on Reddit where they posted creepy folklore from their home country. And it's a lot of things. And I'd like to just read you a few. Ryan, and you haven't read this in advance, so...
That
I
is...
Think,
yeah, I don't know what's what
yeah.
I'm about to hear.
So, I'm going to read you... First one, pretty common. The will-o-wisp is a strange light that lures hikers off trails until they are lost. Folklore is possibly related to a real phenomenon in which people hallucinate when in the wild for long enough and wander around randomly off. This is linked to people seeing strange lights in swamps, bioluminescent insects and flora. But the will-o-wisp, so essentially you're walking through the woods and you see a light and you're like, huh, that's weird, but you follow the light, and then after a while you're lost, you're hungry.
And you have no real choice but to follow the light? Because if I'm in the forest and I see that there's a light, I'm not following that shit if I'm of my own free volition.
Oh, no, I mean, I assume it's just for people who aren't you.
Oh, okay.
That
would, you know what? I feel silly even mentioning it now, because if you think about it, 100% of the people who've been killed by will-o'-the-wisps were not Ryan Brooks.
And also, like, most of the reason I'm not following those things is because I know what a will-o'-wisp is. So I feel like if you don't... I'd say 100% of the people who have been killed by will-o'-wisps had never heard of will-o'-wisps.
That sounds right.
So I feel like otherwise you'd just be pretty dumb.
Yeah.
You know, not to shame anyone who's been killed by a will-o'-wisp, because that's not what we're about here at Drinking Games.
In fact, I think we should probably open up a will-o'-wisp victim charity.
Exactly. Or, like, will-o'-wisp awareness foundation.
Will-o'-wisps on wheels.
If you or any of your friends have ever been affected by will-o'-wisps, please leave a comment below. But I feel like the will-o'-wisp, pretty common, pretty well-known, and an issue, but not a huge... we're going to assume for the sake of it that all of these exist, right?
Sure.
Like, I mean, clearly they don't, but we're for the sake of this, I'm sorry I couldn't get to you. We were dealing with the same monster.
Gotcha.
But for the sake of this, it's all the same. So, another one, and I hope you're okay with me using this term in your household, but a skinwalker.
Say it right, Joey.
Niaglushi?
That was not bad. You know, maybe go into what skinwalker is for a minute, and then I'll say, like, the actual term. I think that might...
Okay, so skinwalker is a witch. In order to become a witch, in Navajo, I believe.
Yep.
Among other, I believe, in indigenous cultures. Because there's also a wendigo, which is,
yeah,
like,
right.
A skinwalker can be a wendigo, but a wendigo isn't necessarily a skinwalker. It's the
yep.
whole...
They both follow the witchy way, as
yeah,
I believe
exactly.
they call it.
Yep.
Real name.
Yeah.
I thought it
yeah.
sounds neat, doesn't it?
Yeah. But it is a... In order to become one, you have to engage in cannibalism or incest.
Or necrophilia.
Yeah.
Or murder. I think those are the four. There might be more.
I don't think murder. I don't think murder qualifies you immediately. I think it's what you do with the corpse that does.
It could go either way, because I know the Navajo don't view death as a natural thing. They think that if someone dies, it's because something went horribly wrong.
That's interesting.
Yeah. So, the native term for the skinwalker is the Yinalushi.
Okay.
And that directly translates to, with it he goes on all fours, because part of the skinwalker myth is that they wear the jewelry of the bodies that they have corrupted, and that's the source of their evil power, and gives them the ability to transform into animals such as wolves.
They also are supernatural assassins.
Yeah, they will take like rotted fragments of bone and flesh and use it in a blowgun, and they will try to shoot a splinter of bone into your neck to infect you with like the death, and apparently in a few days, like because of the curse, you will pass.
So, you know, that's some scary shit.
One thing that's also, I know we said like suspend your disbelief, let's say all these are real,
yeah.
But the reason, like the way that I learned about skinwalkers in the
right.
first place
Same.
Was from a professor, or not a professor, I don't think he had that, but a teacher.
Yeah. I feel like he professed.
Yeah, he absolutely. I don't know if we've mentioned him, but Jim Kristoffic.
Shout out to our boy, Jim Kristoffic. If you would like to sponsor us.
That'd be amazing.
Yeah,
Um,
or just hang out sometime. Like,
that too. Shout out to you in Taos, New Mexico. Yeah, he read his book also, Navajos Wear Nikes.
Yeah.
And he is such a man of science, logic, and reason, but he explained skinwalkers to us as just a real part of living in Navajo culture. And that everyone has a story of running into a skinwalker.
Including him, he gave first-hand experience.
Yeah.
So that
so
was...
these are evils that you don't want to trifle with.
Yeah, also, you shouldn't be saying it in your house if you believe in them. But, this isn't my house.
Oh,
so.
Yeah, I forgot about that one. Or at night, yeah.
The phrase is, to see is to be seen. That is the reason why you don't want to refer to them. Because,
that is very interesting.
Right? So, also, if you see their face, they either try to kill you or disappear, depending on who you're asking.
Right, shit.
Yep.
I was trying, but...
Yeah.
So if you do manage to, like, you're supposed to protect yourself with a light of some sort,
uh-huh.
because if you are able to shine a light on them and see them for their true identity, it reverses all of their evil powers back onto them. And then they just sort of implode into dust.
That said, if you're, like, trying to escape them and you go into your house and turn your lights on, they're not going to stop. They now know you're in your house. They're not, like, movie monsters.
Yeah.
Like, they are smart. They used to be human.
Yeah, they're not Nosferatu being killed by the first rays of
exactly.
sunlight.
So, is that really all the information we want to give on that? Because I don't know what else there is to say.
On
skinwalkers?
Myths? Oh, on skinwalkers.
No, I've got more. I want to talk to you about a Finnish myth.
Is that the horse one?
Yeah, okay. Way to ruin the illusion that you were not prepped beforehand.
I mean, I
this
really
is,
wasn't. You told
no,
me that there's a
the
weird
one,
horse one.
This is the one that I mentioned, and that's the Nakhi. And that's,
How do you spell that again?
N-A-umlaut, K-K-I.
Oh, because I was going to say, Naki, N-A-A-K-I, is Navajo for the number two.
Huh. Wow. It must be the same.
Probably, yeah.
No. So, it lives in lakes and rivers. I'm sorry, this is a different one. Lives in lakes and rivers. Looks like a beautiful lady, but it's half fish and will drown you if you come close to it. And it's the whole story is used to scare children away from water.
Is water all poisonous there? Like, what's the
I think it's just to keep your kids from drowning.
Alright.
I mean,
It's a little excessive, but I mean, but I don't know how firm you have to be with Finnish children.
I don't know how many kids you need to tell, like, hey, so it's gonna look like a beautiful lady, but it's trying to kill you. Like, that seems weird.
That's not really a kid problem, I don't think.
No.
Like, a 7-year-old's like, oh, I'm gonna tap that even though it's half fish. Whoops.
Also, how do you tap it? Like, maybe it gives you a nice head, but, like, I think that's the best you can expect from fish woman.
You know what? My knowledge of fish anatomy is not where it should be. So, that sounds accurate, though. I don't know what a fish vagina is like.
I don't think they, like, have a vagina in the sense that mammals do, so...
Where does all the little dudes come out?
From an egg sac?
So the vagina spits out eggs, then.
Okay.
It's all the same.
You're freaking me out, man.
Joey, when you know as much anatomy as I do...
Now, you keep saying the word anatomy. And I kind of love it, so just keep...
You know, I'm also familiar with physiology, if you want to go there, too.
Oh, good. I've been waiting to talk to you about physiology. I'm still looking for, like, certain... Okay, Baba Yaga. Let's talk about Baba Yaga.
Love it already. What is Baba Yaga?
Okay, Russian folklore.
Oh, God.
She lives... It's an old woman who lives in the deep forest, in a wooden house. That house... is probably a small shack, right? Just typical old woman shack house, Hansel Gretel style thing, right?
Yep.
Okay. You go in that house, it's bigger on the inside, right? That's how she gets you. Now you're in, like, her labyrinth. So it's pretty freaky already. House moves around, though. You can never find the house, you know, in the same place twice, and that's because the house has chicken legs that it uses to travel around. I'm so sorry, I tried. That it used to travel around the forest.
Are you telling me that the entire house, in lieu of a foundation, has just, like, 600-inch-long chicken legs beneath it that just scurry at once like a millipede?
Yep. Oh, no, it's got, just...
Or is it two giant chicken legs?
Two chicken legs.
That runs like around like an ostrich.
I like where you were at, but no, it's just two chicken legs.
Are they giant or are they normal size?
I think they're big.
That's... Who would believe that? Who would start that?
Now, here's the thing, is that you see this in a few cultures.
Is it always chicken legs?
No.
Sometimes it's guinea hens?
No, often it's not even legs. But you see it in...
Chicken tentacles?
Yes. No, you see it in... Hansel and Gretel was the example I used already, but that's part of it, is that it's a woman who invites you to
her party mansion.
Yeah, her unrealistic house, because you look at it one way and it's one thing, but you look at it another way, it's another thing. You have the small house that becomes big, you have the house made entirely of candy. It's just meant to just, like, scare you. Not to scare you, to lure you in, but she, then the house moves around, and it's debatable what she does with the house. Like, does she eat you, does she, kill you, does she
taxidermy.
Drive you to madness? Yeah, exactly. But, like, that's, because Hansel and Gretel, that's German.
Yeah.
That's a far stretch.
Oh, son of a bitch, I'm gonna die.
Yeah,
okay.
Me too.
I'm on my way.
Okay. Oh, no.
I forget, like, what the original Hansel and Gretel actually was, like, too. Because I know that there were a couple details that were slightly altered from the versions that we hear.
Right. But, you know, I feel like that's one worth noting.
Tell us about the sticky horse.
I don't have it up yet. I'm getting there.
Oh, okay.
I just want to keep going for a little bit. The stick. You know what? I'll go with the sticky horse.
I like the sticky horse.
I don't have the name on me, and I don't have the culture. But once I find it, if I find it, I will bring it up. But it's a horse that hangs out near lakes, and it's like kind of gluey, that if you touch it, well, all horses are gluey, but if you touch it, you're stuck to it, and then if someone tries to like touch you to free you, then they are stuck to you, and so you've just got this chain of stuck people to the sticky horse, and then the sticky horse walks into a lake and kills you all.
Here's what the sticky horse didn't count on, though. You use its strength as a weakness. You just get as many people as possible to just dogpile onto this thing to the point where it can't even walk anymore. It's crushed under the weight of all of these people who have worked together to obliterate the sticky horse.
I believe that was how the Icelandic people did eventually conquer the sticky horse. So if you ever see a sticky horse, grab your village and just go to town just conquering the sticky horse.
No sticky horse is too powerful, too daunting. Like, you can do it.
Yes, exactly.
No horse is too sticky.
Believe in yourself, and you will be able to destroy them. So, we did pass our timer.
I think I want to make this, like, a longer episode, though, because I could keep doing this. What do you think?
I want to continue this, so we're going to call this part one, and then have part two release at the same time, but for the sake of editing... it's going to be, the render time is going to be longer.
Ah, right.
And it already takes about an hour per episode at 20 minutes, so I don't want to bump that up any more than I have to. So in that case, we're going to see you, oh shit, look at the moon.
Yeah, it's cool, right?
Yeah. But we're going to see you next time, where we do more of the same, because we're really enjoying this, I feel like. I am.
Yeah.
All right. So keep it spooky, and we'll see you soon. Any closing remarks? Like, subscribe?
I would do one more for the road, but I'm out of grenades right now.
That's fine.
Do you want a duel to end this?
No, here. One for the road.
Woo! Yeah!
So, the last thing I want to say is I want to pose a question to all of our viewers. Trick or treat, comment, and let us know.